Good afternoon, students. Today I'll be sharing the proof of two theorems. One is your side, then I'll come to RHS, and one more proof. Three proofs only I'll be sharing with you today, and tomorrow we'll look for their application part. So let us see what's about your proof of SSS. No doubt that this proof is not the part of your syllabus, but just from the knowledge sake point of view and understanding point of view, because then your understanding part will be clear in a better way. That is the purpose, to discuss the proof of the same with you. So what we are talking about? Congruency in triangles. So here are the two triangles given to you. One is your A, B, C, and another is your D, E, F, in which their corresponding sides are given equal. Mean to say, when you are speaking about SSS, one side is equal to this, this is equal to this, and this is equal to this, then I need to prove triangle ABC is congruent to triangle DEF. One proof already we have finished, that is your ASA, and that is there in your syllabus. And corollary of the same I used, that was AAS. So second proof now I am discussing with you. No need to give any proof to your SAS, that is simply a paper cutting activity, as you can use. And I am applying this. I proved with the help of SAS, ASA, and AS, as I said, that the property which you are going to prove, like here I am going to prove SSS. So I am nowhere allowed to use SSS in this proof. So you can use ASA, you can use AAS, or you can use SAS to prove the same, but not SSS at all. So here, when we are speaking to prove these two triangles congruent, you need to go for construction. So what is the construction required here? At this vertex E, you draw any angle EG such that your this AB is equal to EG. This is the condition. So here you need to construct an angle ABC. Whatever the degrees are there, those should be the degree of your GEF. So mention the construction, that is from E, draw EG, then that line of angle you can cut in such a way that EG is equal to what? AB. When you will be producing this line, cut an arc, EG is equal to what? AB. That is the condition. Please take care of this. And the degrees of these two angles, that is of ABC, this is another condition you need to fulfill during this construction, is equal to what? Your angle GEF. And then you can join this G with F. That also you can mention. GF and this D with G. This you join. So this is the construction you need to do. Now in proof, look at these two triangles, that is your ABC and EGF. Triangle ABC and triangle EGF AB is equal to GE. I said here by construction, and your angle ABC is also equal to angle GEF. This is I did by construction, and your BC is given equal to EF. BC is equal to EF. So this implies triangle ABC is congruent to triangle GEF by SAS. So now whole of this triangle I have proved congruent to this triangle. Then your this angle BAC will be equal to angle EGF. And another thing you can write as per your CPCT, that is AC will be equal to GF. CPCT, and give it number 1. As you have proved the triangles congruent, so their remaining parts always I can write equal. So I mentioned this whole angle, that is your this angle, now I have proved is equal to this angle, and the side, that is your AC, was left. I have proved is equal to GF also. So I will be using at a later stage of this proof somewhere this result. That's why I have given the number 1. Now you see, you said somewhere it was given that AB is equal to DE. This was given. But now here also you said AB is equal to EG. Also AB is equal to GE. That was by construction. So therefore DE somewhere I am finding is equal to EG. So this DE and EG I am finding equal. So therefore if this I am putting is 1 and this I am putting is 2, can I say angle 1 is equal to angle 2 in triangle DEG? Of course, yes, because when the opposite sides are equal, if you are saying that DE is equal to EG, DE is equal to EG, then this is an isosceles triangle and the angle opposite to these equal sides will always be equal. So 1 now I have said is equal to 2. So similarly, can I prove that angle 3 will be equal to angle 4? This angle 3, if I am marking here 3 and here 4, so can I say that angle 3 will be equal to 4? Same construction can be done in that way also. What we have done at E, same we can do at F also. So then in the same manner I will be able to prove 3 is equal to 4. Now you add this. If you add this, so you will be getting angle 1 plus angle 3 is equal to what? Angle 2 plus angle 4. Very interesting now. What happens? 1 plus 3 is your EDF. And now this is coming equal to what? EGF. And somewhere you take this is equal to 2. In 1 you said EGF is equal to BAC. In 2 you are saying EGF is equal to EDF. So by comparing 1 and 2, from 1 and 2, EGF is equal to BAC, EGF is equal to EDF. So can I say ki EDF, that is this angle 1 plus 3, somewhere is equal to angle BAC? Of course, yes. So this is also BAC, this is EDF here, EGF, this is equal to EGF, this is also equal to EGF. When 2 are equal, then other results also will be equal. So BAC will be equal to EDF. So if BAC means this angle, I have proved now is equal to this angle. So therefore, come back to your those two triangles, that is your ABC and DEF. What happens now? This side is equal to this side, given that is AB is equal to DE. This side is equal to this side, that is AC is equal to DF. And the included angle, that is BAC, I have proved is equal to EDF. So hence triangle ABC is congruent to triangle DEF. The criterion now is equal to what? SAS, which we have to prove. So the two triangles now will be congruent by SAS. So this is the proof for your SSS. Next proof, which is applicable to your right triangles only. So that is called RHS. So I'll be sharing with you. Again, that is not a part of your syllabus. But RHS means what? So RHS somewhere is applicable to your two right triangles. If suppose I'm speaking about one right triangle and another right triangle here, this is your ABC and this is your DEF. This is right angled at B, this is right angled at E. And hypotenuse is always equal to H, stands for hypotenuse. R stands for right angle. R stands for right angle. And you are saying one side, suppose I am taking this side is equal to this side. So this stands for S. So when the situation is like this, in two right triangles, conditionally hypotenuse is very important. That must be equal to each other. And one of the side you can choose, either this side is equal to this side or this side is equal to this side. and another angle is your right angle. So that you have to take. In that way, the two triangles are congruent by RHS. So I need to prove here, if these are given equal, means I have to prove triangle ABC is congruent to triangle DEF. So again, you go for the construction here. What is the construction you need to do is, you just extend this DE somewhere, again up to G. So extend DE up to G such that this EG is equal to AB. This EG is equal to AB, and then join you this G with F. Join GF. Now, in triangle ABC and GEF, in your proof, in triangle ABC and triangle GEF, see, AB is equal to GE. And definitely your angle B will be equal to angle E, 90 degree each. This is by construction. This is by linear pair. You can see this is 90, so this also will be equal to 90 degree. And your BC is given equal to EF. BC is equal to EF. This is given. Again, what happens? Triangle ABC, I'm getting congruent to triangle GEF, and again the congruency I'm getting, like previous cases here, SAS. Once the triangles you have proved congruent, that is this triangle is congruent to this triangle, then what happens? So AC will be equal to now GF. AC will be equal to GF. And here this angle A will be equal to angle G. That is angle BAC will be equal to angle EGF. This is CPCT, and give it number 1 again. You said AC is equal to DF. That was given. AC is equal to DF. AC is equal to DF. But you are saying AC is equal to, also AC is equal to GF. So then AC is equal to what? GF. So therefore your DF will be equal to GF. Is it or not? Yes. So then if this is angle 1, this is angle 2, again your angle 1 will be equal to what? Angle 2. Because if this side you have proved is equal to this side, then opposite angles will always be equal. So angle 1 is equal to angle 2. So now comfortably you can read these two triangles which you need to prove congruent. That is your ABC. You have proved what? This angle is equal to this angle. This side is equal to this side. Angle 2 you are saying here is equal to angle 1. But already you have proved this angle A is equal to angle G. So if angle A is equal to angle G is also equal to angle 1. So your angle 1 will also be equal to angle A. That is angle A and D are also equal. This is equal to this. This is equal to this. So when two angles you have proved are equal of these two triangles ABC and DF, the third automatically will be equal. But that does not mean that angle congruency is there. Now you are free to apply. Either you go for angle side. This angle is equal to this angle, this angle is equal to this angle, and this is given equal. If you are picking the third angle, once you have proved this is equal to this, then third angle automatically will be equal. So then you can say this is equal to this given, this angle is equal to this angle proved, and hypotenuse again is given. So then I can say that these two triangles are congruent by SAS. So RHS I can prove either by your ASA or by your AAS or by your SA. S. So that is the proof for your RHS. Then on behalf of this RHS, another common property, That is the last part I am sharing with you today from the application part of your next exercise point of view. In an isosceles triangle, you know, you have studied already, if this angle is equal to this angle, then prove that if angle 1 is equal to angle 2, so I have to prove AB is equal to AC. That is a property of your isosceles triangle. So what you can do here is draw the perpendicular AD. Draw AD perpendicular to BC. And now in proof, you study these two triangles. In triangle ADB and triangle ADC, one is equal to 2. Angle 1 is equal to 2. And your angle D, so angle D, that is your ADB, ADB will be equal to your angle ADC. Definitely 90 degree each. Again, the property you are using is linear pair axiom. So ADB will be equal to ADC. If this is 90, so this also will be of 90 degree. And your AD is equal to AD. Number 1, 1 is equal to 2. Number 2, this ADB is equal to ADC. And third, I am saying AD is equal to AD. So by AAS, two angles, one angle, this is equal to this, this is equal to this, and the side. So therefore triangle ADB is congruent to triangle ADC by AAS, angle, angle, side, angle, angle, side. So AAS congruence is there, so therefore AB is equal to AC, therefore AB is equal to AC, that is your CPCT. So if the angle, base angles are given equal, then the side opposite to those angles are always equal. So this is by AAS. Similarly, you can prove the converse also. In converse, what happens? Now given will be this. So if AB, now this is given, I need to prove this. So I will not go in detail. Here you can see. Now only the subject of your theorem will change. In place of AAS, you will be using RHS. Why? Because this is equal to this one, that is your hypotenuse. Angle is here, again same construction, that is R, that is H. So R for this here, H for this, and the common side AD again will be there. So now in these two triangles, ADB and ADC, AB will be equal to AC, given that is the hypotenuse. AD is equal to AD, that is the side, and angle, this will be equal to this, that is the right angle. So then the two triangle ADB and ADC will be congruent to each other by RHS, and then by CPCTC, comfortably you can write 1 is equal to 2. So these all are the proofs which you need from the application point of view in the next exercise that we will start tomorrow. Thank you.